Quick follow-up to my 40-30 balancing clear problem video that I uploaded about a month and a half ago now. The number of comments that were left on that video from you guys that said you had experienced the same problem was very surprising to me. And I have to correct something that I said in that original video. I said that if you have a bottle of 40-30 with the factory seal on it, this would last a very long time. Apparently that was not the case. A number of you guys left comments saying that you had bottles dry up with the factory seal still in place. So I apologize for that information. I emailed Createx. My email read, I recently had an issue with 40-30 balancing clear and uploaded a video on YouTube to share the issue with others because I think it is information that users of the product should be aware of. You can find the video here. This is the first time I've experienced this issue. However, based on numerous comments left on the video, it appears many others have experienced it too. Is there an explanation or a better way to prevent this problem from happening again? What causes the product to cure? I'd be more than happy to create a follow-up video with answers straight from the experts. To be clear, my video was not intended to put Createx products down in any way, shape, or form. I use your products on a daily basis and will continue to do so. And just to reiterate, that last statement still holds true. This is not me trying to bash Createx or their products in any way. I still use their products on a daily basis. I will continue using their products. They're fantastic products for what I do. I did get a response. The response read, thank you for contacting Createx Colors. Please let us know the batch code to the affected bottle of 40-30. This can be found listed above the barcode in a fine print alphanumeric sequence. Also, please let us know which dealer this was purchased from, as upon reviewing the batch code, we will authorize a return replacement through said dealer. We are aware of many past issues with the 40-30. However, the issue was fixed in spring of 2019. This product is susceptible to freezing and cold temperatures and affected by high heat, so it's best to store this product at room temperature always. The good news is Createx customer service, based on my own personal experience, has always been fantastic. They will take care of you. If you have this issue and you contact them, they will replace the product. The bad side is that's kind of a blanket response. You know, they said they were aware of many issues with 40-30, but the issue was fixed in spring of 2019. Whether or not it was actually fixed comes down to more or less a bad batch is the way that I read that, which to me is kind of a blanket excuse. I went fishing for a little bit more information, so I replied to their reply. And my reply read, thanks for the reply. Unfortunately, I've already discarded the bottle that solidified and I didn't think to jot down the lot number before doing so. I have another 16-ounce bottle that I'm relatively certain was purchased at the same time, if that helps. I also can't seem to find the receipt showing where I purchased them. I'm not worried about getting the product replaced either though. Based on my own past experience, I know Createx is a fantastic company that stands behind their customers and products. I'm more interested in sharing with my viewers the cause behind the problem and what was done to fix it. I can understand how a bad batch can occur within a large manufacturing process, but that's kind of a blanket excuse. I'd like to get a little more technical if possible. I was already aware issues can occur with large temperature swings. I purposely do not order paint during winter for that reason, but we can't control the heat in the summer either. My studio is a temperature controlled environment and none of my paint is subjected to direct sunlight. Does humidity or moisture in the air play a role in the curing process? I was surprised by how many comments were left on my video from users who said they experienced the same issue with unopened bottles with the factory seal still in place. Any further information you can provide would be great. Prior to this email exchange, I was already aware of the problems associated with shocking paint with temperature. I purposely do not order paint during the winter months unless I absolutely have to, because freezing paint, especially when it comes to 40-30 and the UVLS clears, is a bad idea. That will cause problems that the paint cannot rebound from. The same thing can happen during high temperatures as well. We can't always control the temperature during the summer. You know, where I'm at, it gets up into triple digits relatively easy during the summer. So that's something to be aware of if you weren't aware of already. Unfortunately, I never got another reply from Createx after I sent my reply. I don't know why. I didn't think I was asking for too much information or any trade secrets or anything like that. So after I didn't get a reply from that one, I sent another email to somebody who is higher up in the Createx company or the Colorcraft company that I have dealt with a little bit before. Now, I'm not going to read this entire email to you guys, but I will put it up on screen so that you can pause the video and read through it if you're interested in what I wrote. Basically asked the same questions, and again, crickets, no replies. So the upside is, again, that Createx does stand behind their products. They will replace a product if you have a problem. But as far as the answers, I don't know. It's interesting to me that Createx initially said to me in the first reply that they were aware of many issues with 4030 in the past, but the one issue was fixed in spring of 2019. They were aware of many issues. Why is only one fixed? Or am I just reading that wrong? Was it typed wrong? I honestly don't know, guys. We talked a little bit about the cheap bottles and the cheap caps that Createx uses in my previous video. To date, the makeshift seal that I put on this bottle, whether or not that's actually having any effect, I don't know. But this bottle is still liquid. I haven't changed the way that I stored this bottle in any way since the last video. I am going to change that now, and we'll go over that in just a minute. Talking about the bottles, I mentioned in the previous video that I wish Createx would come up with a better container, at least a better cap for their bottles. And it turns out they already have one that's being used. If you order a 32 ounce or a 16 ounce AutoBorn sealer, it comes in one of these containers, which is probably more UV resistant because it's not translucent like these are. And the cap is 10 times better because you don't have to worry about the little flip top cap having residual buildup of paint and not allowing that to seal correctly. So hopefully in the future we'll see this bottle trickle down into the other Createx lines. I ordered a 32 ounce bottle of UVLS clear recently, and it actually comes in this bottle. This is still a translucent bottle, but the cap is much better because you don't have the flip top cap. So that keeps it more airtight. As far as whether or not UV has anything to do with causing these products to solidify in the bottle, I'm not 100% sure on that. I did go back to the technical data sheets and I found something interesting that I have overlooked in the past. If you look at the 4030 technical data sheet, it reads, keep 4030 capped airtight when not pouring from the bottle. Store away from direct light in a cool, dark environment such as a paint cabinet or box in a closet. That verbiage is there for a reason. Createx is telling us that it's probably not a good idea to subject our paint to UV light. And UV light doesn't just come from the sun either. There is some degree of UV light that comes from artificial light as well, like the lights you might find in an artist's studio. What's very interesting to me is I went back and looked at every single Createx technical data sheet for all of their products. And that verbiage, not verbatim, but some form of that verbiage actually exists in every single Createx technical data sheet. So Createx recommends that across the board. To date, I have stored all of my Createx paint in the rack I showed you guys just a few minutes ago, and I've never experienced an issue with any of that paint except for that one bottle of 4030 Balancing Clear that solidified on me. I know some of you guys have experienced that with more than one bottle. From here on out, I'm going to start storing my 4030 Balancing Clear and my UVLS clears in a cabinet out of the light, just to be on the safe side. I'm hoping that what Createx told me is true, that the issue was resolved in spring of 2019 and we will no longer see this problem from here on out. I can see in a large scale manufacturing process how a lot of product that was not part of that fix could still be in circulation out there. Hopefully that's dwindling down and or gone at this point, seeing as how we're getting close to 2021. Hopefully it's been resolved. I can't tell you guys for sure whether it has or it hasn't. I wish Createx would have at least replied to my other two emails, even if they said, look, we're not going to give you any further information. It's pretty disappointing on my end that they just ignored my further questions. It is what it is. That's the best information I can give you guys. Again, hopefully it's fixed and we won't have to deal with this anymore, but time will tell. So I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you guys next time.